Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So today we will start our new lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Body movement. Okay, so in this body movement we are going to discuss what is meant by movement, how the human body is doing the movement, and with the help of the human body how the other animals too are doing the movement. Okay, so as we know there are the three living things present on the earth, that are human beings, animals and plants. Okay, so the human beings and animals can easily move from one place to another place. Okay, but like the animals and the human beings, plants are also showing the certain types of the movement. Okay, so how they are showing that movement, which body parts we are using, which organs help us to do the movement, all these things we are going to discuss in this lesson, that is what? Body movement. Okay, so let's start to eat. So in our body there are the so many movements are going on every time or every second of the time. Okay, so we can say that our heart get contract and relax to pump out the blood throughout our body. Also we can say that with the help of our eyes we can see the different types of the objects which are present around us. Okay, with the help of our upper jaw and the lower jaw, or with the doing the movement of the lower jaw, we can chew the food, we can grind the food into the small pieces. Okay, so like that these are the so many movements which are going on in our body which are not in our control. Okay, so the contraction and the relaxation is not in our control. Also we can say that whenever we are doing the breathing process, that time our chest comes up. When we inhale, then the chest comes up. When we exhale the air, then it goes to its back position. Okay, it comes to its normal position. So in this way there are the so many movements are shown by the different organs. Okay, so there are the so many movements which are going on in the body. So let's discuss what is mean by movement. What is the definition of movement? The change in the position of any part of the body with respect to its axis is called movement. Okay, so what is mean by the movement? The change in the position of any part of the body, the change in the position of any part of the body with its axis, okay, with its axis is called as what? Body movement, or it is called as what? Body movement. Okay, so we can say that this is, I'm standing here. Okay, so all the human body is having one axis. Okay, so see here, now I can move my hand. Now I'm moving my hand with the help of my body axis. Okay, so see here, this is the movement. Okay, this is the movement means what? I am changing just position of my hand. Okay, so this is about what? Movement. We can blink our eyes, that is also the one type of the movement. We are doing the certain types of the activities, that is also the movement. Okay, so movement means for just changing the position of any parts of the body. We can see up, we can see down, left, right, with the help of our neck. So what we are doing? We are doing the movement, we are just changing the position of our neck. Okay, so this is about what? Movement. Animals and the human beings, plants are also showing the movement. We know that mimosa plant, or we can say that what? Touch me not plant. If we touch it, then it closes all its leaves. Okay, sunflower is trying to keep the face towards the sun, that is also the one type of the movement. Okay, so the movement is very important in living organism for the survival. Okay, or to survive properly on the earth, the movement is necessary in plant, in animal, and as well as in human being also. Okay, so now we'll move for the next point, that is what? Locomotion. What is mean by locomotion? It is very important, student. Very, keep in the mind, see, movement is different and the locomotion is different. In the movement, what we have seen? The changes, the change in the position of any body part with respect to its axis. Means just changing the position of any body parts. It is called as what? Movement. Then what is mean by locomotion? Let's see. The movement of the whole body of an organism from one place to another is called a locomotion. Okay, so in the locomotion, what happens? The whole body can move from one place to another place. Okay, see here, now I'm standing here, now I will walk. So I have changed my position, it means what I have done? I have done the locomotion. But if I move my hand, then now what I have done? I have do the movement. Okay, so movement means what? Just change the position of the body, while the locomotion means what? The whole body is moving from one place to another. The movement of the whole body of an organism from one place to another is called what? Locomotion. Okay, so the different organisms are showing the locomotions in a different way. If you talk about the human being, then the human being can walk to go from one place to another place. If we talk about the some animals like that, we can say about the horse, then horse is running. Some animals are showing the movement with the help of the swimming. For example, we can say that fish is there. Some animals are flying in the air. For example, what we can say? Yes, you are correct. Who is flying in the air? All the birds are flying in the air. Okay, some are showing the hopping, or some are doing the hopping to do the locomotion. We can say that kangaroo is there, frog is there. They are doing what? Hopping to change their body from one place to another place, to take their body from one place to another place, and that is only we are calling as what? Locomotion. Okay, so in this way, locomotion is very important in all the living organisms. Let's see why the locomotions we are doing. See here, it is very important point I want to tell you, that the plants are showing the movement, but the plants are not showing the locomotion. Okay, plants cannot go from one place to another place. They are just showing the movement, but the animals and human beings can show the locomotion, or they are doing the locomotion. Okay, now we will discuss that why the locomotion is important. That is what? Importance of locomotion. So the first thing is that the locomotion is important for is what? Find their food and water. Okay, so the animals are doing the locomotion to find their food and water. So see, it is very important. If they will sit on the one place, then it is not possible to get the enough food and the water. To find the food, to get the enough water and food, they have to do the locomotion. Next one is that to protect themselves from their enemies and predators. Okay, so as we know, the herbivorous is the food for the carnivorous. Okay, so the herbivorous have to do the locomotion if they want to protect from their enemies and from the predators. Okay, so the animals are doing the locomotion to protect themselves from their enemies and predator. Next one is that to move from the unfavorable condition to the favorable condition, or we can say that to move from the unfavorable environment to favorable environment. That is only we are calling as what? Migration. Some animals are showing the migrations. Okay, means they are coming out from the very harsh environment to the favorable environment. Okay, so Arctic crane is there, different birds are there, those who are showing the migration. They are coming from the different places in the favorable condition. Okay, next one is that very important to find a suitable places for laying eggs. Okay, to lay the egg, they want the safe place. Okay, to search that place, they have to do the locomotion. Find a suitable places for laying eggs, or also rearing their young ones. To take care of their young ones, they also need the safe place, and to find out that place, they have to do the locomotion. Okay, so in this way, all these are the reasons for that what locomotion is very important. So this is all about the locomotion. So hereafter we will discuss that how the body is doing the movement, or how the human body is performing the different types of the movement. But before going to see that how the body is performing the different movement, we will see that which body parts helps to do the movement and the locomotion. For that purpose, we have to take the look inside our body. Okay, it means what? We will discuss the different bones which are present in our body. Okay, so let's start for that. So now let's discuss about the next point from the lesson, which is very important. That is what? Skeletal system. Okay, so now we will start the next organ system. That is what? Skeletal
system. Okay, so the skeletal system, it means what? What includes in the skeletal system? All the bones which are present in the body, all these bones comes under what? Skeletal system. Okay, so let's start. What is mean by skeletal system? The framework of all the bones in our body is called the skeleton. Okay, so the framework of all the body, okay, framework of all the bones, the framework of all the bones in the body is called as what? Skeleton. It is called as what? Skeleton. Okay, so the human body is made up of 206 bone. Okay, in an adult human being there are 206 bone. Okay, so that human body is having the proper shape and size. Okay, so these are the certain bones that we can count by feeling it or by touching it. So how do we know what is the shape of the human body? So we can come to know the shape of the human body, or the we can come to know the shape of the bones by feeling them. Okay, so this is the one way, with the help of that we can come to know what is the exactly shape and the number of the bones. Also there is a one more way, is that with the help of the x-ray we can come to know about the shape and the number of the bones. Okay, so nowadays if there is any fracture is there in the bone, then doctor advises us to take a x-ray of that particular body parts. Okay, so who discovered that x-ray? So there was a one German physicist, and the name of his was William Conrad Roentgen. Okay, so he discovered the x-ray in 1859. Okay, and he also discovered that x-ray rays can pass through the tissues, but it cannot goes through the bones. Okay, and nowadays this x-ray system or this x-ray technology, the doctors are using to find out if there is any fracture is present in the bone or no. So with the help of this x-ray and with the help of the feeling certain bones, we can come to know the shape of that particular bone. Okay, so the adult persons are having 206 bone, while the child has 305 bones. Okay, why is it like that? The child is having 305 bones because as the child is get grown up, that certain bones get fused, and at the age or at the adult stage the bones become how many? 206 bones. Okay, so in a child there are 305 bones, and as the child is getting grown up, certain bones get fused with each other, and then at the adult stage the bones become, the number of the bone is what? 206. Okay, so in this way the bones are present in the human beings and in a child. Next one, we will see the functions of skeleton. Okay, so in the image, before going to see the functions of the skeleton, you can see the image of the human skeleton, and these are the certain bones which are present in a human body. There are the so many different types of the bone, how many? 206 bones are present in human body, and about all these bones we are going to discuss in our next sessions. Okay, so this is the structure of human skeleton, and now we will discuss about the functions of skeleton, why the skeleton is important in human body. So the first one is that skeleton gives a shape and support to the body. Skeleton gives a shape and support to the body. Also skeleton protects the delicate internal organ. Skeleton helps to protect the delicate organs in the body. For example, we can say that brain is there, which is get fixed into the skull. Okay, because of the skull our brain cannot get damaged very easily. The heart and the lungs are get protected inside the rib cage. Okay, in this way all these are the internal organs are get protected with the help of the skeleton. Next one is that helps in the movement of body parts. Okay, helps in the movement of the different body parts, like that skeleton help us to walk, to stand straight, to run, to move from one place to another place. So in this way these are the certain functions of the skeleton. Okay, so here we will stop. We will meet in the next video, and that next video we will discuss the next point. And for today, thank you.